died 1.5 years ago.
It's like sometimes I can feel her around me.
Mom?
You have to be very careful. If you call out to one of the dead, all of them can hear you.
So when it came to actually getting the part and shooting this, I mean, was it a little bit intimidating? I mean, working with Lynn and with Dermot, you know?
It was a really welcoming place, you know? Our first scene I shot was the first scene of the movie with Lynn, and she's just an incredible human being. So I enjoyed working with her so much, and Dermot's great. He's a sarcastic guy.
So how intimidating was it taking on this film? Because I know you were part of the first two, and this time, you know, they gave you
the big guns.
Yeah, it was intimidating stepping into the director's chair. I'm not someone who naturally wants to, you know, stand on top of the box and say, hey, everyone, look at me, do what I say. Like, as a screenwriter, you're kind of trained to lurk in the shadows. You know, a lot of the time you feel like you're not even...
when the actors get the words wrong.
Yeah, exactly, but you're complaining to yourself because no one wants to listen. And so that was interesting. I had to get used to the idea that all these technicians and craftsmen who are so great at their jobs and have been doing this for so long were all listening to me. And that took a while to get used to.
I don't know what's real, and I don't know what to do to stop it.
What's happening to me?
I had a vision of you. A man couldn't breathe. This entity is very dangerous.
I mean, I actually heard that you went to go see a psychic.
I did.
For the prep for this. I mean, how did that go?
Great. Lee sent me to him, and it was an incredible experience, yeah.
I mean, was there anything kind of profound that happened?
Or yeah, you know, everything that he's predicted has come true so far.
Really?
Mm-hmm.
What was one of the things that he said that you can share?
I think that, like, definitely when it came to work, he predicted a lot for all the roles that I got the rest of the year. They were all kind of exactly what he would say.
Is it kind of fun shooting a horror film, or is it actually draining?
Well, we worked really hard, so there's that aspect of it. I love it, and we all did. We took this movie on as a troop, you know. Mm-hmm. Lee was a great leader. He'd written the other two Insidious movies and appeared in them, and directs this one. So it was a great movie-making experience for me.
And Lynn, how great is it that you just keep coming back to these films? I mean, we can't get rid of you. You're one of, like, the fan favorites in this film.
I can't get enough of it. I mean, first of all, I've grown so in love with the character and with the storytelling that, you know, from the beginning. So for me, really, what drove me into acting was people, story, character, and this has all three for me, and I'm really excited the fact that people seem to receive Elise with such a sort of real affection.
Jumped.
For me, Lynn is like, she's a total psychic. Like, she totally plays it by the book. It's like, I totally believe it, that she has a gift, you know?
Getting to know Lynn Shay, she really is a magical person in one way or another. I can't identify exactly what it is, but for her to reprise this role, really to be resurrected in the role, because she gets killed in Insidious 1.
Yeah.
Right, so we go 6 years back in time, and we get this incredible, really almost superhero performance out of Lynn Shay as Elise, this really favorite character that people... that people love from the other movies comes back in spades here. And really the flip side, working with a newcomer actress, I was really impressed with Stephanie Scott, who's the heart of the movie, and worked her tail off to make it great.
How difficult was it shooting this film?
I mean, it was definitely like an emotional and physical roller coaster, but I'm all in. Like, I love that stuff. I love dark, twisted material. So to once we really got into it, it was so fun. And I love doing my own stunts.
Yeah, quiet.
I'll be waiting in the dark when the pain finally kills you.
No!